Free, free Palestine!
Free, free Palestine!
And we all need to be behind Palestine.
In general, the world leaders is letting the people down completely.
الناس أتت لتثبت إنه إرهابكم لا يخيبنا.
Stop supporting Israel. I'm fed up with it.
We'll fight Free Palestine today, tomorrow, next month, until it's free.
أهلا وسهلا حبايبي، إن شاء الله تكونوا كلكم بخير وصحة وسلامة وعافية، وحياكم الله في فيديو جديد في أمستردام هولندا. اليوم يا جماعة هذا الفيديو زي ما أنتم شايفين الساحة دام سكوير اللي نصور فيه دائما ممتلئ بالأعلام الفلسطينية إذا تصور هنا، لأنه في مظاهرة كبيرة جدا، أعتقد هي الأكبر على الإطلاق في تاريخ هولندا بتكون للقضية الفلسطينية. ما زالوا الأعداد بكثرة يجوا من محطة القطار، والآلاف متواجدين هنا في هذه الساحة، ساحة دام سكوير، الساحة الرئيسية في أمستردام. إيش بنسوي في هذا الفيديو؟ بكل بساطة بنسوي مقابلات مع الناس اللي هنا، أجانب أو عرب، وفي أجانب بنسبة كبيرة. بكل بساطة نسألهم أنت ليش هنا؟ ليش تقف مع القضية الفلسطينية؟ فقبل ما نبدأ الفيديو يا جماعة، لايك واشتراك في القناة لو عدو ما اشترك. Free Palestine! معلومة مهمة يا جماعة، واحدة من لجان النظام أعطتني هذه الورقة تقول إذا تم اعتقالي اليوم، إذا حصل وتم اعتقالي أتصل لهذا الرقم للمساعدة، لأنه في تشديد جدا، عناصر الشرطة الهولندية موجودين بعدد كبير جدا، ما قد حصلته كذا من قبل، فلا قدر الله وصار أي شيء يقولوا اتصل بهذا الرقم إذا صار أي اعتقال. الله يستر. Can you please tell me your name and where are you from?
I'm Dutch.
I'm French.
Also Dutch.
Okay. Why are you here? Why you support Palestine?
We recognize the intense violence is being done to the Palestinian people.
Be free Palestine.
We want to stop the genocide.
Yeah, it's a solidarity support against genocide and also occupation, and we all need to be behind Palestine.
Yeah, same. I'm very afraid that Israel is gonna really go for genocide this time, and I've been following their cause for quite some years, and this is really a next step, and I think it's really important that a lot of Dutch people show up today to show that.
Yeah, it's really nice, but you have the Prime Minister Mark Rutte is fully backing Israel and haven't said anything about the genocide, and you have also Macron. So what do you tell them? What do you tell your Prime Minister?
This is very dangerous how they now unconditionally support Israel. It gives them carte blanche to do whatever they want, and they really, really need to watch their own words and watch who they are supporting.
Why do you think they do this? They give unconditionally support?
That's a very good question. I don't think I have an answer, but I do think there's a lot of ties between Israel and the Dutch government or the French government, which economic ties, but also political ties, it's hard to break.
I know that Israel has a very big role in the arms industry and also giving intelligence to Western countries. So I think these ties are what prevents them from really speaking out against what's happening now. And I would really like to say to Rutte that despite what happened last Saturday and what Hamas did, and whether you agree with that or not, I think you should also recognize what is happening now and the severe threat that people
not have. Only now, what's been happening since 75
exactly.
years.
Right? Yeah, exactly, exactly.
You have to bring the historical context yes. to any problem,
yeah.
right?
Yeah, the context is really important.
What's your name?
Jules.
And you from?
I'm from here, Amsterdam.
Amsterdam. Why are you here? I see you have the Palestinian kufia. Why?
I support the Palestinian cause, and the oppression of the Palestinian people must end. So that's why I'm here, to show my solidarity.
What do you tell your Prime Minister? You know, Mark Rutte has fully backed Israel and what they do, and never has said anything about the Palestinian who died, at least 700 children. What do you say to him?
I have many things to say to him. What I know is that our Prime Minister Mark Rutte, he's not a stupid thing. He knows these things happen. The worst thing is that he is choosing to close his eyes and to only tell one narrative.
Why do you think is that?
It's in the interest of the Netherlands to support, unfortunately, the state of Israel, to maintain control in the Middle East. But also there's a sort of historic shame in the Netherlands towards Jewish people, and I know Israel and Jewish people are not correlated, but somehow he decides to translate that in that way.
Do you say that the historical bad thing they have done to Jews here, they try to justify it now by, and the Palestinians pay the price now?
For sure, for sure. Like they decided, like Palestine was a colony of the British, and you know the things that happened to the Jews here were horrible. But they didn't like Jews here in Europe either. So they were like, okay, we just sent them there, and it's not our problem. Now it's the problem of the Palestinians, and they don't care about the Arabs or Palestinians at all, especially back in the day.
شو اسمك؟
كريم.
كريم من وين؟
من غزة.
من غزة. وأسرتك كلها هنا؟
الأهل هان وفي هناك ستي وسيدي والحمد لله.
كيف وضعهم بغزة؟
والله لا في مية ولا في أكل ولا في علاج أصلاً.
تقدروا تتواصلوا معهم؟
لا والله ما في نت.
متى آخر مرة تكلمتوا معهم؟
قبل 4 أيام.
ولسه والآن مش عارفين لا وين كيف وضعهم ولا عايشين ولا ميتين ولا عندهم أي خبر؟
ولا شيء. ولا عارفين وين هم ولا عارفين وين موجودين ولا عايشين ولا ميتين.
وين بغزة بالضبط ساكنين؟
في الرمال.
في الحي اللي قصفوه يعني البقوع. كيف شايف المظاهرة؟
والله الحمد لله يعني يمكن يصل الصوت لأوروبا ويشبكوا النت على الأقل أو نعرف نتواصل معهم أو يوصل أكل شرب مية أي شيء الحمد لله.
خايف على ستك وجدك وعلى؟
أكيد خايف أكيد.
إن شاء الله تسمعوا منهم الأخبار الحلوة ويكونوا بالسلامة وتتحرر كل فلسطين إن شاء الله. شكرا يا كريم
حبيب.
شكرا. شوف إيش أعطاني كريم. Free Palestine علم فلسطين. شكرا
حبيب.
Free Palestine. I see this and it's very new information to me. Can you tell me a little bit about it?
So this is a political prisoner in the Netherlands who was arrested because he is fighting a good cause, helping Palestinians.
When he was arrested?
I think in the 22nd of June.
This year?
This year, yeah.
What's your name?
Anna.
And you're from?
Denmark.
Denmark.
Yeah.
And are you here because you're supporting the Palestinian cause?
Definitely.
Why you support?
Because this has been too many generations. I can't let our generations have just been seeing this happening for too long, for 80 years. And it's, I don't have words for it anymore. This is just happening while we're all watching. And yeah, my heart is bleeding for this. Our prime minister is also letting down. I have no respect left for her because she's also out supporting Israel in this battle that is happening right now, and I have no respect left for the in general the world leaders is letting the people down completely. I don't have anything nice to say to them at all. I think they're disappointing and on a scale that is out of this world.
I'm Anna Rosa and I'm from Italy.
You know the Italy prime minister, and they are supporting Israel fully. They back them what they're doing, and they never, until now, never said anything about the killing and the genocide happening to people in Gaza and cutting off water, food, electricity. What do you say to that? How do you feel as an Italian, as a European?
I don't feel good. I think the Europe and all the nations of Europe are, like, they're demonstrating that they are hypocrites because they are not telling the full story and they're not telling the full history behind what is happening. And they're only taking one side, and they're kind of, in my opinion, they're kind of making like a propaganda also, like the papers are only saying one side of the story or not. Yeah, they're deciding not to say anything in support of Palestine and about the occupation and the apartheid in Palestine.
Can you please tell me your name or where are you from?
Johanne, from Denmark.
Brechia, from the Netherlands.
Okay. How do you feel today? Like so many people here around, I guess at least 5-10,000 people. How do you feel?
Kind of overwhelmed and a bit emotional too.
Yeah, also really emotional but also hopeful. It's it feels really powerful to be with so many people together and chanting. Yeah, emotional and powerful.
الأمطار بدأت تنزل شوية. انتهت الوقفة والكلمات والبرنامج اللي ألقوا في الساحة. الآن في مسيرة كبيرة جدا بالشارع. متجهين قرابة ساعة بنمشي إلى مكان معين نمشي مع الناس. والأعداد الصراحة كبيرة جدا جدا وما قد حصلت مسيرة كذا. حبيبي شكرا. والحقيقة يا جماعة إنه هذا أقل شيء نقدر نسويه. أنا الثلاثة الأيام أو خلال الأسبوع الماضي بكيت يمكن 4 أو 3 مرات والله من القهر والغل. لكن لما تجي هنا هذا أقل شيء تسويه وأقل شيء.
فلسطين فري فري فلسطين
فري فري فلسطين
شايفين الحماس شايفين الناس شايفين هيك كل واحد جاي يخرج غلبه يخرج غضبه يخرج زعله يخرج قهره يصيح بكل صوته هنا مش عرب ولا مسلمين فقط الأوروبيين من كل الدول الأوروبية موجودين وبكثرة حتى اللي قابل المقعد حقها شوفوا كيف هاي يعني ما فيش كلمات اقدر احصلها اكثر اوصف المشاعر والمكان والاجواء اللي هنا. شو رايك اليوم؟ كيف شعورك وفي الاف الناس هون اوروبيين وعرب مسلمين من كل مكان؟
انا اقول لك بالرغم من الارهاب والنفاق الذي تمارسه الأنظمة الأوروبية والدول الأوروبية مجتمعة والغرب كله، إلا أن محبي فلسطين كثر وإن شاء الله يزدادون يوما بعد يوم إلى التحرير. الناس أتت لتثبت أن إرهابكم لا يخيفنا كما يفعل أهل غزة الآن. إرهاب الصهيونية لا يخيفهم، وهنا ضغط وإرهاب وقمع الغرب لا يخيفنا.
My name is Diana and I live in the Netherlands, but originally I'm from Chechnya.
Why are you here? Why do you support Palestine?
Because this is not normal. We're crossing human rights. It's a genocide and we have to stop it.
And how do you feel that so many people here? Tell me a little
my
bit about your feelings.
My heart is in my throat.
That's a very nice expression.
I came from Friesland all the way here. And I'm very happy I came here.
Worth it, right?
Yes, very worth it.
How do you feel that so many people came here today? I've never seen so many people like this in Amsterdam.
I feel angry that we have to do this. That we have to do in 2023, that we have to do this, that we have to stand on the streets, walk this movement, because the world order refuses to stand up for innocent people. And at the same time, I'm proud that I see this many people. I'm proud that this many people are standing up for innocent people in the world.
I'm Sander, I'm from Amersfoort.
From the Netherlands?
Yes, from the Netherlands, yes.
You came all the way from Amersfoort to here, why?
Because my government supports Israel and I want that to stop.
What do you say to your Prime Minister, Mark Rutte? They are fully backing Israel and haven't said anything about the 700 children killed in Gaza.
Well, recognize the rights of the Palestinians right now. That's all I have to say. Stop supporting Israel. I'm fed up with it.
You seem very angry and you have so many feelings.
Well, yeah, I'm fed up with it. You know, for years and years, my government is supporting Israel. But they're committing crimes and ethnic cleansing the indigenous population. Palestinians is the indigenous population of the country. And they are, like, wiped out. So I'm fed up with it.
What's your name?
Carolina.
And?
Tian.
Tian. Welcome, Tian, my channel. And you come out of Netherlands, too?
Uit Nederland, yeah.
Okay. Why are you here today? Waarom zijn jullie hier vandaag?
Omdat we het heel erg vinden dat iedereen eigenlijk gewoon wegkijkt en de politiek wegkijkt. En Palestijnen uitgemoord worden al 75 jaar. En dat kun je gewoon niet laten gebeuren. En ik denk terug aan de Tweede Wereldoorlog. Dat iedereen wegkeek toen er zoveel mensen vermoord werden. En nu kijken mensen weer weg. En dat kan ik niet laten gebeuren. Dus we moeten hier gewoon zijn.
How did you get that Palestinian kufia, this one?
My friend. My friend, where is he? I don't know where he is. Oh, there he is. Okay. Yeah, he gave me. It's
nice. How do you feel that so many people today came here? So many people in Amsterdam. How do you feel? Describe your feelings.
Amazing. Shocked. I did not think so many people show up.
Very heartwarming. Look at all the people right now. Everyone knows that this is the right cause. Yeah. This is the right movement.
Right? Yeah. And one last
Human
thing.
Rights.
Do you want to... Now, the people in Gaza, they might be watching us right now. What do you want to tell them? What do you want to say to them?
Free Palestine!
Stay strong, we're all with you.
We're with you, we hear you. We'll fight Free Palestine today, tomorrow, next month, until it's free.
No matter what the cost is.
Okay, let's hear one more time. Free, free!
Palestine!
Free, free!
Palestine!
Thank you. زي ما انتم شايفين يا جماعة في نسبة جدا كبيرة من الحضور أجانب، مش عرب ولا مسلمين، أوروبيين، هولنديين وغيره. اللي ماسكين اللوحات هنا يطالبوا الاتحاد الاوروبي بوقف المجازر والوقوف مع اسرائيل، كلهم هولنديين اوروبيين وجايين ومصلحين لوحات وكاتبينها على كراتين وبالاعلام. هذا اوكران. هلو، كان اس يو كويستشن، ما رضيت تجاوب، لكن هذا اوكران كمان ويقولون انهم واقفين مع فلسطين. فالقضيه ازيد من كونها قضيه عربيه واسلاميه، هي قضيه انسانيه.
نتنياهو تيرورست.
نتنياهو. Where are you from?
I'm from Rotterdam.
So you're Dutch?
Yes.
And why are you here today? You support Palestine?
Yes, I support Palestine. Israel is a fascist state. They've been supported by the West for 75 years. Even though last Nakba commemoration, a UN diplomat, a Dutch guy, spoke and informed us that even back then, when he was active as a diplomat, rules have been made by the UN. and they have never been sanctioned for breaking them, never.
Your Prime Minister Mark Rutte is supporting Israel and Dutch government, European Union, what do you tell them?
I tell them, fuck you, what do you mean now is not the time to ask questions? They're supporting genocide. He's not even our Prime Minister anymore and he dares to take such a firm stance pro-Israel. Fuck him.
And what do you tell the people in Gaza?
That and stay strong. Palestine will never die. We cry for you. We fight for you.
Let's hear one more. Free Palestine.
Free, free Palestine.
Free, free Palestine.
Free, free Palestine.
Free, free Palestine.
فلسطين عربية.
فلسطين عربية. إذا يا جماعة كذا كان فيديو اليوم وهكذا كانت المسيرة اللي صراحة جدا صدمتني وأنا مذهول إلى هذه اللحظة. عشرات الآلاف من الناس حضروا هذه المسيرة لصوت الحق لقضية فلسطين لأنها قضية عادلة. اجتمع هذا العدد الكبير ومش بس فلسطينيين ولا عرب ولا مسلمين، عدد كبير هولنديين وأجانب وأوروبيين وصلحوا لوحات بأيديهم وكتبوها وضبطوها، واللي جاي ميكروفون واللي جاي يصيح لأنها قضية عادلة والحق واضح ومعروف. أجاءت هذه الأعداد الكبيرة. فالفيديو كان ربما طويل شوية، أتمنى استمتعتم يا جماعة، وهذا علم فلسطين معنا موجود في النهاية بالرغم من هطول الأمطار. الناس مشت المسافة الطويلة جدا وأكملت المسيرة هذه بأعداد جدا كبيرة. فاللايك اللي عاد ما سوى واشترك في القناة اللي عاد ما اشترك. فري بالستاين، وإن شاء الله يجي يوم ونشوف فلسطين والأراضي الفلسطينية كلها محررة من هذا الظلم ومن هذا الطغيان بحقهم، ويرجعوا كلهم لأهلهم للأراضي الفلسطينية. قول إن شاء الله، وإحسان يتلو إحسان حتى آخر لحظة في الحياة. السلام عليكم.